Measurements and their uncertainty. This section will look at accuracy and precision and help you understand the difference between the two. So, connecting to your world, there's that globe again. What's the problem with it? Can you figure it out? So, connecting to your world, you might remember that the Mars rover, when it landed on Mars, one of its jobs was to analyze the geology as well as the climate by making measurements. And all those measurements have an uncertainty. So even though they came up with a number, there's always a plus or a minus to that number. So some terms we need to know in chemistry are accuracy and precision. Accuracy is how close a measurement comes to the true value of the object being measured. So we like to use a dartboard with all the darts in the center. You know you're 100% accurate because they're all located where you want them to be. Think about accuracy as a density that's measured by an expert and published in a scientific journal. And you can look up that density and compare it to the density that you calculate in the laboratory. You can determine your accuracy. Precision is the ability of a measurement to be reproduced consistently. So for example, you're playing darts and all your darts go in the same spot. You have good accuracy, and good precision. Let me go back one slide, I kind of went quickly. Here you have good precision because they're all in the same spot, but poor accuracy because you really want them in the center. If you get them in the center, you have good accuracy and you have good precision because all your darts are located there. In this example, we have our poor accuracy and our good precision. And in this one, we have poor accuracy as well as poor precision because your darts aren't together. They're not precise. In class, you can think about using a scale. That's what you use to mass your reactants and products, and say the scale is not calibrated correctly. So when you put something on to measure its mass, it's giving you a mass, and you're always getting the same value whenever you mass it, so you have good precision, but there's poor accuracy because the scale is not calibrated correctly. So there's one true chemistry laboratory example. Two calculations you will make quite often are percent error calculations. So be sure to write these two down so you can refer to them. Percent error is your accepted value minus your measured value. Take the difference between them and then divide by the accepted value and multiply by 100. We'll practice this in class. The absolute percent error is when you take the difference between your accepted and measured value and you give it an absolute value, so you know it's positive. Whereas with regular percent error, you can have a negative percent error. It just means your measured value is bigger than the accepted value. Calculations otherwise exactly the same, except you are taking the absolute value of the difference between the accepted value and the measured value. So make sure you have those in your notes and you can find them.